Russia has a new planning interspecies munition for both the Ducktales and the Tornado-S, which is capable of surpassing in effectiveness even the formidable Fabs with omics. We will return to this right after we list the most interesting events that took place in our country during the week. So, there was a solemn ceremony of launching the salvage and towing vessel Mikhail Chekhov of Project 22870, built under the order of the Russian Ministry of Defense. The vessel is capable of keeping emergency ships afloat and performing complex diving operations at depths of up to 60 meters. In addition, Mikhail Chekhov can perform tasks of collecting oil products from the sea surface, as well as search and survey operations. JSC Shchelkovo Agrochem launches a new workshop for the production of fungicides, insecticides, and mordants with an area of 4,952 square meters. The main feature of the new shop is fully automated filling lines, starting with the feeding of canisters to the line and ending with the receipt of finished packaging products. Investments in the project amounted to about 1.8 billion rubles. The Vologda plant of TransAlpha assembled the head sample of the first batch of Sirius electric buses for St. Petersburg. Sirius electric buses are equipped with a climate control system, multimedia panels, voice announcements, USB charging stations for gadgets, and comfortable passenger seats. All cars for St. Petersburg are 100% low floor, with seats for people with limited mobility. One of the most important preparatory stages of the turbine for startup, idling, which will be completed by switching on to the grid and gaining load, has been successfully carried out at the Kyrgyzskaya Grisa. In order to check the operation of the protection, the turbine will be accelerated to a speed of 3,300 RPM. The results of such a startup showed that the equipment works without any remarks. The vibration level is not exceeded. All systems function normally. Scientists at Novosibirsk State Technical University have developed an airplane-type cargo drone designed for aviation, agricultural work, cargo delivery, and long-term monitoring. It is capable of lifting cargoes up to 100 kilograms. The design of the wing and fuselage provides for the possibility of mounting various systems, spraying, or seating. Specialists from Rosneft's research institutes in St. Petersburg and Krasnoyarsk conducted successful pilot tests of the technology for producing lithium carbonate from hydromineral feedstock produced at the Yurubchino, Tokomskoy, and Kubinskoy fields. Lithium carbonate is the main raw material for the production of lithium hydroxide, which is used for the production of lithium batteries and steel foundries in the pharmaceutical industry, as well as in the glass and ceramic industries. A new production facility for ceramic bricks was launched in the Volgograd region, with an investment project cost of RUB 1.7 billion. The modernized enterprise has doubled its brick output from 15 million to 33 million conventional pieces per year. The Russian plant Tonar produced an upgraded articulated dump truck T-45. The all-wheel drive three-axle dump truck with inter-wheel and inter-axle lockable differentials is designed for transportation of 45-ton cargo. New hydropneumatic front suspension struts were installed on the machine. The front frame was lengthened by 320 millimeters to allow installation of an automatic transmission. RT Information Security presented at the forum a domestic system RT protected EDR for detecting and counteracting cyber attacks. The system analyzes objects in mail and internet traffic, monitors network activity, and performs anomaly analysis based on the collected data. The program is capable of replacing similar solutions of foreign vendors on the Russian market. A new electroplating section was opened at the Cheboksary Electroapparatus plant. The lines are fully automated, 5 galvanic lines are in operation, and by the end of the year the production will be replenished with 4 more sections with updated equipment. About 800 million rubles have been invested in the construction. And now let's move on to the new planned interspecies munition, which is capable of surpassing in effectiveness even the formidable Fabs with OMPK. The Hell Duckling or Gromokriak never ceases to amaze with its versatility and flexibility in the choice of firing guests, from the usual cast iron to the latest D-30SN OMPBs. This weapon has been in use only in April, but it is already showing its best side. The official history of inexpensive Russian smart bombs, based on old proven Fabs with a universal planning and correction module OMPK, began with a small photo on the channel of a famous blogger in January 2003. Many people then laughed at the not particularly aesthetic appearance of the weapon shown. Western experts, in their usual mocking irony about any Russian weaponry, called the then new product a poor parody of the US JIDM system. However, as early as May of 23, the voices of skeptics subsided, and panic notes began to sound more and more frequently. The system did not just take root in the Russian Air and Space Forces. Today, the former parody is called the main strike baton of our best frontline bombers, Although the Su-34 has a lot of well-proven means of fire defeat even without SOIMPC Fabs. Within a year, the guided modules were put on stream and made great strides in terms of accuracy. The Ducklings have mastered their new weapon so well that they have become a strike system, without which it is already difficult to imagine a modern Russian army. But, as we know, there are no limits to perfection. And I am sure that very soon, in relation to the Su-34, we will hear more and more often another formidable abbreviation UMPB. And not only for our dear ducks, but also for another extremely dangerous and unkindly mentioned in the West, the Tornado-S multiple rocket launcher. By the way, it is the Tornado-S that is considered the most promising carrier of such munitions. The Su-34 has many tasks as it is, and the launch of the 8mRS from the former Tornado will leave no one indifferent. Its high-precision range more than doubles. In the second half of May 2024, a curious video with objective control of the use of projectile bombs, which are quite unusual for the Russian arsenal, was shown for the first time. Officially, they are called Universal Interspecies Planning Munitions UMPB labeled D-30SN. The very idea of such a projectile is not new, and back at the beginning of this millennium, it was proposed by developers from the Moscow-based NPO Basalt. At that time, the concept did not take root in large aviation, but on the basis of basalt developments at the end of the last decade was created a small corrective aerial bomb 50 kilograms for the Russian reconnaissance impact drone, Orin and Nakhodets. It is believed that it was this development that became the basis for the D-30SN first demonstrated in May. In terms of the principle of operation and technical characteristics, it is similar in many respects to the American JBU-39 BSDB and partly to the French hammer planning bomb. Due to good aerodynamic properties, noticeably better than conventional Fabs, with wings D-30CN is able to fly at a distance of up to 120 kilometers, carrying a warhead equivalent to FAB-250. War is also about economics. According to the incoming information, the cost of the new munition will not differ much from the price of FAB-500 with WMDK. To increase the range of such a bomb missile can be equipped with a pulse jet engine, thanks to the modular layout, but this has a noticeable impact on the power of its warhead. In addition, as already stated, the new projectile is unified with the Tornado-S MLRS and becomes another type of smart and relatively inexpensive ammunition for our flagship MLRS. The range of the D-30SN in this case grows to 250 kilometers. Judging by the fact that its wreckage in recent days quite often demonstrated by various military products of Europe and the United States, we are no longer talking about experimental batches, but about some significant seria. Here's the D-30SN UMPB in its native element. Warzone Portal tried to compare our UMPB with another USPC wonder weapon, JLCDB bombers used in HIMARS launchers. However, it is the JLCDBs that have become one of the main disappointments of the last year, as they are too dependent on the GPS signal, which is actively suppressed by Russian RAP systems. The same problems, by the way, turned out to be with the same dams, although the Russian dams are not hampered by electronic countermeasures for some reason. As far as we know now, the use of D-30SN recognized as a success, and they have already begun to produce a large series. There is reason to believe that in the near future we will hear about these new munitions no less often than we hear about the FAB sunks, which are constantly in the news,